Hi, my name's Starsky and welcome to From the Studio on Clubbing TV. In this episode, I'm going to be taking a look at the extremely orange and extremely marvellous Analogue Solutions Fusebox. And that little track demonstrates exactly why I love this thing. It's not the sort of instrument where you create a patch and you leave that patch to play throughout your track. Because every time you stretch out and you twist one of these little knobs, you just create a different, beautiful tone, and it's such a shame not to bring out as many as you can in the middle of your tracks. So it's a beautiful thing, but what exactly is it? Well, it's a semi-modular synth, and if you saw my semi-modular episode, you'll know what that means. If you didn't see it, basically it means you can override the internal wiring using these patch points on the front to create all sorts of different madness and mayhem. It's got three oscillators and a multimode filter, so it's got a low pass, a notch, and a high pass mode, and a band pass mode as well. It's also got an arpeggiator and a single LFO, so all pretty standard so far. But then we've got this MIDI to CV converter as well, so you can bring in pitch, accent, MIDI clock, gate or velocity from MIDI. You've also got this MIDI controller 55, which means you can program something on your door with controller 55, whether it be an LFO or an envelope or just some randomness. And this will convert that MIDI data to a control voltage, which means you can control anything on your Euro rack or on this or any other semi-module you like from MIDI data, which is really pretty cool. And then it's got these two strange things at the bottom. It's got this interval generator and a patternator. What on earth's a patternator? Well, we'll look at that in a minute, but first, let's just take a quick overview of like the oscillators and the filters and just get a general feel for the sound of it. So as I said, we've got three oscillators, we've also got noise and we've got a sub, and each of the oscillators is slightly different. Oscillators one and two can have a sawtooth or a square, but oscillator one, for example, you can change the octave. Oscillator two, you can have a wide tune, so it can be a bit more like an LFO. Oscillator three, you've also got a triangle and you've got the wide tune, and you can take the MIDI pitch off as well, so you can even use that as an LFO. So all of a sudden, although it sounds like it's got one LFO, it sounds a little bit simple. When you start looking at what else it's got, it starts to get really quite complex. So let's take a look at this then. We've got a square or we've got a sawtooth, so. So there, modulating the pulse width using this knob here. But we can do that automatically down here with the LFO. Make it a bit longer. So using the wide tune, you really do get low LFOs and really high ones as well. And if you take the wide tune off, it's just like a normal oscillator then. And that detune just detunes it a tiny bit so you can get those really fat sounds when you've got both of them playing. Let's put oscillator one and two on. Let's take the X mod off. Thank you. And that's just two oscillators. Really meaty already, isn't it? Add a bit of release to that. And then maybe let's bring in the sub as well. Let's try and bring in oscillator 3 as well, shall we? Let's patch that in. This doesn't have a switch on the mixer, so let's bring in the sawtooth from that, bring it into this one here. Turn the others off so we can hear it. This also has a wide tune on it as well. Bring it back to normal range. Bring the others in. So there we've got four oscillators running. We've got the main three plus the sub, and it sounds absolutely huge. If you play that through a massive PA in a shoddy building, the roof's coming down, that's amazing. So I think that sort of covers the oscillators for now. Let's take a quick look at the filter. You've heard me playing with the filter, it's really nice. It's a 12 dB, not a 24 dB, so it's a bit gentler than some. So that's just gorgeous, isn't it? Really smooth and silky, but I've got to be really careful doing filter sweeps. I keep on getting copyright claims on my YouTube channel doing filter sweeps on random synths, because obviously they've been used for years now in dance tracks, and just doing this can get me a copyright claim. It's insane. So that's the low pass, and now we can go to a notch that takes out the mid frequencies. And I really like those. And then we go up to a high pass. Everything you do just sounds great. It's also got a band pass as well. That's getting a bit dirtier there, isn't it? But again, sounds really nice. It's hard to describe exactly what the patternator is, because it is a bit weird, but it's like a sequencer, and you've got four steps, and you can play different steps depending on where you set these knobs here. So it's sort of random. It does say in the manual exactly what positions play what steps, but if we just put this in now, so set it off playing to the LFO, put these onto the pattern as well. Now, as I change these values here, different things will happen with the beat. Different beats will play, different ones will drop out. You're getting a constantly changing, evolving patterns, all staying in time, all along the same theme, but just evolving constantly, as I say, as you tweak and you play and you just twist the knobs and everything sounds nice. Absolutely fabulous, that, isn't it? And I know I'll have edited this down because I've been playing that now for about 10 minutes, just really enjoying myself. As I say, when you play this, you don't want to put it down, you just tweak and tweak and tweak. But as this is an alien episode, I have been playing with this all week. I've been playing it with this, actually, which is a prototype of a KGB fuzz pedal by Valco. Valco are a local company to me, and KGB meaning keyboard, guitar, and bass, and I've been getting some really dirty things from this. Valco are a pretty cool company, actually. They make this thing. You may have come across this before. It's their take on the Love Tone cheese sauce, which will set you back about £1,300 these days. And this is only about 300, something like that. Only £300, but yeah, well worth it. But I'll put this through the KGB, as I say, as it's an alien episode, and this is still in prototype phase, although it should be coming out, I reckon, in February 2021, so not that long to wait. I don't know how much it's going to be yet, but it'll look a little bit more polished than this does at the minute. But let's have a listen. So yeah, amazing sounding. As I say, can't get a bad sound out of it, but is it for you? Well, at around £1,300, these are definitely not cheap, but they are absolutely spectacular. The stuff I've been doing this, just demoing it there, would be really difficult to do in your door. You could probably do something similar, but it's just the way the instrument works, especially with this patternator and the interval generator. You're just getting things out of it that would be hard to get from a door. You could probably copy what I've done on that and those patterns and get it to sound very close, but you wouldn't necessarily have wrote them or got to them in the first place, and that's the beauty of something like this. That and the fact that it sounds absolutely amazing. So I hope that was of some use to somebody somewhere, and if it was, don't forget you can catch this whenever you like on our Clubbing TV official YouTube channel, on our From the Studio playlist. And if you are into your synths, as I always say, maybe check out my Starsky Carr YouTube channel, where I've got a lot more in-depth and technical reviews and demos. So I'll see you in the next episode of From the Studio.